Do you think America is exceptional? Well, some college students at George Washington University beg to differ with you if you do. Listen.
Do you believe that America is exceptional?
No, not really.
I feel like at some points in history we were exceptional. We've kind of taken a little downfall.
In some regards, yes, but not in all regards.
Recently, in the last couple of years of my education, I've learned not to always believe the exceptionalist viewpoint we were taught at a very young age.
Oh my gosh. Jonathan, you heard that last girl. Studies show a majority of professors are liberal. Are they brainwashing college students?
Eric, the culture is shaped in the universities, and this is the next generation of leaders and their leaders' advisors that are being taught to hate Americanism. I would be surprised if 1 in 100, maybe 1 in 1,000 of these professors were pro-America, were pro-capitalist. They're the ones that teach these kids that, you know, America's racist, that this country is founded on oppression and it ruins the environment, and that more than anything, the mind, their own mind, the only ability to think is impotent. So they're being brainwashed, and they've been essentially since the progressive era of the 1920s.
And Juan, it seems like it's getting worse and worse. More and more liberal, more and more Americans, not exceptional, more PC, more safe spaces. You can't say a word on campus.
Eric Bowling, you and I both know young people are dying to get into Fox to work. We see young people working hard. These young people are reacting to their reality, which is less mobility, harder to get ahead now, harder to get a job in many cases, some of the issues we discussed in the first segment. And so they're saying they don't see that the United States is all that different, let's say, than countries in Western Europe, where there's more mobility, more ability for them to get in on the ladder of upward mobility into the middle class.
Or, Mercedes, or the first thing President Obama's first foreign policy speech was in Cairo saying, guess what? No more. America is not exceptional. We're the same as everyone else.
What a horrible lesson to teach. But I have to tell you, it is the role of the parents. And you know, Eric, you know our family. We've got 5 girls. And I feel that it is so important to instill in these young people, look, this is what it is to be a conservative. This is why conservatism can help move America forward. And really, I mean, we teach them about William Buckley, Ronald Reagan, Barry Goldwater, in understanding that you take this material as parents we give to our children and go up and go debate the professor and go tell them why they're wrong on these liberal policies. And I think that that's where it starts.
Quick thought, John.
I just wish there really was Americanism out there, Eric. I think both parties, unfortunately, have it wrong. I mean, the left, it's all about I am my brother's keeper. On the right, it's all about country first. The whole point of Americanism is that you own your life. It's your life, your liberty, your happiness. You're not a sacrifice to anyone else.
Well, I think these kids have a lot of debt, you know, college tuition debt. I think they're worried about health care. They don't always have coverage. And that's why you see them saying, this is not brainwashing.
You know what?
This is reality.
Cashin In, America is exceptional. It will continue to be exceptional.
Yeah.
We leave it right there. Coming up.